Hey guys, in this video we'll discuss about coagulation of blood. So what does it mean, coagulation of blood? So coagulation is nothing but blood is flowing in a liquid state in the blood vessel, right? So if that liquid state blood is converting into a solid like mass, like a jelly like substance, we call it as a clot or coagulation, right? So that coagulation is mediated by many of the enzymes. So that is why we call it as a cascade of the coagulation reaction, right? It is a chain of reaction what is happening in the coagulation of blood, right? So when your blood vessel ruptures, there are three stages in which blood will be stopped. So first stage is vasoconstriction, second stage is platelet aggregation, third stage is coagulation or formation of the clot. So we are talking about the formation of clot in this video. So I told many substances are involving in the formation of the clot. So those includes 13 factors. That is, factor 1 is also called as fibrinogen. So always remember, fibrinogen, it is a inactive form, it is ending with gen. So prothrombin is called as factor 2, it is also a inactive form. Third one is thromboplastin, which is also called as tissue thromboplastin, we should remember, because factor 11 is again plasma thromboplastin, right? So factor 4 is calcium, factor 5 is Lebel factor, factor 6 presence has been not detected yet. Factor 7 is also called a stable factor. Factor 8 is called as anti-haemophilic factor. So if the patient develops deficiency of this factor, we call it as a disease called hemophilia. Factor 9 is called as Christmas factor. Factor 10 is called as Stewart-Prover factor. Factor 11 is called as plasma thromboplastin. Remember, the factor 11 is plasma thromboplastin. Factor 3 is tissue thromboplastin, factor 12 is Hegman's factor, factor 13 is a fibrin stabilizing factor. So the name itself says it stabilizes the fibrin. So what does it mean? Fibrinogen should convert into fibrin and that forms a clot, right? So we'll start. This coagulation happens in two pathways. One is extrinsic pathway, one is intrinsic pathway, right? So we'll start how exactly both pathways work. So I told there are two pathways which involve in the formation of the clot, right? So here is the intrinsic pathway, here is the extrinsic pathway. So simple to understand, intrinsic pathway is triggered by the substances which are involved or which are present in the blood or which are present in the plasma itself, while as extrinsic pathway is triggered by the factors in which tissue is being damaged. So when tissue damage, some substances has been released, they trigger the formation of the clot, right? So how to remember, external is from external, it is not coming from the blood. Intrinsic is from internal, which is from the blood itself or from the plasma itself, right? So we'll start. First thing, whenever there is a damage of the blood vessel, whenever the intrinsic pathway, how it is triggered, first thing happens is factor 12 will get activated. Factor 12 will get activated, right? So 12 is converted into 12A. So which is the 12th factor? That is Hegman's factor, right? So this Hegman's factor, whatever is activated, it will mediate the reaction and activate the factor number 11, right? So 12 is activating. So the activated factor 12, that is Hegman factor, which is gets activated, will activate the factor number 11 to 11A. So what is the factor number 11? So that is tissue thromboplastin, right? So the 11A, the tissue thromboplastin, whatever was activated, it will activate the factor 9. So what is the factor 9? That is Christmas factor, right? So Christmas factor is activated by activated plasma thromboplastin, right? So factor 9 will get into 9A. So A is nothing but which is activated factor. So this activated Christmas factor, this activated Christmas factor with the help of anti-haemophilic factor, that is factor 8 and factor 4, that is calcium, right? So with the help of factor 8 and calcium, what will happen? This will activate the factor number 10. what will get activated? Factor 10 will get activated. So which is the factor 10? Factor 10 is the super factor, right? So let's talk about extrinsic pathway. So extrinsic pathway is triggered by tissue thromboplastin. In the presence of factor number 7, right? In the presence of factor number 7, it will activate again factor 10 to 10A, right? So what is the target of both extrinsic and intrinsic pathway? It is activating factor 10, right? So now we have activated factor 10. So this activated factor 10 will activate which factor? That is factor number 2, which is also called as prothrombin, right? So this activated factor will activate factor 2 to 2A. Means prothrombin is converted into thrombin. So what will happen next? Prothrombin will convert fibrinogen to fibrin. That is factor 1 to 1A, right? So factor 1 is fibrinogen. The fibrinogen is an inactive form which will get activated with the help of prothrombin. Right, so now fibrin has formed. So this fibrin, whatever is formed, it is not such a strong or which is not completely stabilized form, and this activated fibrinogen will be stabilized. So that is stable fibrin with the help of which factor? Now we should know, that is factor number 13, because factor number 13 is the fibrin stabilizing factor, right? So this is how the stable fibrin has been formed. Once fibrin is formed, it will form the strong clot, right? So this is the story of our blood coagulation, right? So how to remember intrinsic pathway? First we'll start. So that is factor 12, that is Hegmann's factor. And next factor which comes is Christmas factor, right? Next factor, sorry, this is tissue thromboplastin. The next factor which comes is Christmas factor, right? So how to remember HTC, right? HTC is involving in intrinsic pathway. HTC with the help of, after HTC what will happen? Anti-haemophilic, right? And calcium, right? So with the help of calcium, what will happen? It will activate the factor number 10. So how to remember this? HTC antivirus cost. So cost, let's call, write it like this. So HTC antivirus cost $10, right? And here how to remember, tissue thromboplastin is a third factor, and 3 plus 7 will combine to give the 10th factor. It is a mnemonic to remember. Keep following, guys. Thank you.